Hello students, welcome. In this session, we will see insert, delete and update statements in the SQL. Let us see inserting data into tables. Once a table is created using create table command, the next most natural thing that we would like to do is inserting the data into the table, right? When inserting a single row of data into the table, the insert operation would do two things. First is create a new row or empty row in the database table. Next is load the values passed by the SQL insert command into the specified columns of that row, right? The syntax for that would be insert into the table name and the column names and the values. In that, whatever the value that you want to pass into the column 1 should be put up in the expression 1, right? Similarly, the values that you want to put in column 2 should be put up in the expression 2, right? That is to say, there is one-to-one mapping between the column names and the values that occur here in the values, right? Let's see an examples. Insert into GK tab, register number, name, gender, date of birth, and course. Values 101, that is in the register number column. In the first row, probably 101 is inserted. Then in the name column of that same row, Varsh G. Kalyan is inserted. Similarly for all other things, right? And if you only want to insert register number and name, you can only give insert into JK tab in this register number comma name. I close this round bracket and then values 101 comma Harsh G Kalyan and close the round bracket here, right? Let's see another way in which you can insert the values in the table. Insert into JK tab values. You have to mention the values for all the columns of that particular row. You cannot skip any value in this. Right? The major difference between this syntax and this syntax is that if you are using this second syntax, here you have to mention the value for all the columns of the row. You can't have anything. But if you are using this, you can only have two columns and only give values for two columns. If the table is okay with it, or the table constraints are okay with it. Right? Hope it's clear. And now, whenever you are trying to work with the data types like char, varchar, or varchar2, date, those values should be put up in a single quotes, as you could see in this. So varchar is put up in a single quotes, character single quotes, right? Date single quotes, right? Let's see delete operations. The delete command deletes rows from the table that satisfies the condition provided by its where clause, and that returns the number of records deleted. So it will delete records based on specific condition that you give in the where clause and then give you back the number of rows it deleted, right? Within this delete, you can delete all the rows or you can delete specific rows based upon the condition which you will mention in the where clause. Thus, the verb delete in the SQL command is used to remove either all the rows from the table or a specific rows from the table. Let's see removal of a specific rows. The syntax is delete from table name where this is a condition. The SQL mention from which row it has to delete. For example, here delete from JK tab where register number equals 103. It means that delete the row where the register number is 103. Hope it's clear. let's see removal of all rows. That is to say, you want to delete all the rows. Syntax is delete from table name. There is no where clause here. In this case, what happens? It will delete from table everything. All the rows are deleted in this. Because there is no where clause in which we haven't specified any conditions. Thus, it deletes all the rows from the table. Updating the contents of the table. The update command is used to change or modify data values in the table. Right? As it says, we would like to update a values in the table. The verb update in the SQL is used to either updates, that is all the rows from the table, or a selected set of rows from the table. That is to say, if you want to update a column to a new value for all the rows, or you want to only update for a specific row, those things can be done with a update command. Right, let us see each one of them. Updating all the rows for a particular column. The update statement updates the columns in the existing table rows with the new values. The set clause is used for this, and it indicates which column data should be modified and the new values that we should give it to the column. The where clause, if given, specifies which rows to be updated. If you don't give where clause, all the table rows are updated. See the syntax here, update table name set. After set, you have to give the column for which you want to give a new value. So column name equals expression 1, comma, column name 2 equals expression 2. If you close like this, then all the rows, for all the rows, this column 1 and column 2 would be having a new value, that is expression 1 and expression 2. Right? Let's see an example. Update the GK tab table by changing its course to the BCA. Right? Update GK tab set course equals BCA. So, in this case, the course column is updated to BCA for all the rows. Got it? Let's see updating records conditionally. If you want to update a specific set of rows in the table, then we can use a where clause along with the update and set. The syntax is update table name set column name 1 equals expression 1, comma column name 2 equals expression 2, where particular condition, so that it will only update for particular row which satisfies this condition. Let's see an example. Update GK tab table by changing the course BCA to BBM for register number 102. For this, update GK tab set course equals BBM, right? Where register number equals 102. So it will only go to the row which is having register number 102, and in that only the course column would be changed to BBM, but not the all the rows. Okay, I hope you got it. In this, it will go to the row which is having register number 102, and then within that row only the course column would be changed to the BBM. All other rows will be intact. Right? Thank you.